predicting the future of insects by studying their past. Insects are one of the most important groups of organisms on Earth and have been around for over 400 million years. Although there are gaps in the fossil record, insects contained in amber and sedimentary deposits give us clues about their evolutionary history and ecology. Dr. Conrad Labandeira of the Smithsonian's National Museum of Natural History examines insect fossils to answer important questions with implications for today's species. His team investigates how insects interacted with their environment, when particular adaptations evolved, and how insects have responded to global changes. This research helps us predict how modern insects might respond to a changing climate and other environmental pressures. The evolution of insects and plants is intricately linked throughout their history, and some of the most important ecological events occurred during the Cretaceous period. In the middle of this period, from about 125 million to 90 million years ago, cone-bearing plants were replaced by flowering plants as the dominant vegetation. This switch, called the Cretaceous Terrestrial Revolution, had profound effects on insect pollinators. Dr. Labandeira's work helped answer an age-old chicken and egg question. Did insect pollination or flowers come first? Through extensive research, Dr. Labandeira and colleagues identified four pollination modes that existed before flowering plants emerged. First, they examined a false blister beetle trapped in Spanish amber along with pollen from a cone-bearing plant. This provides compelling evidence that this beetle's feeding behavior facilitated pollination during the Cretaceous Terrestrial Revolution. Similarly, the researchers examined four thrips specimens covered with pollen. They believe that donut-like rings around hairs on the abdomen and wings of these insects represent a specialized structure for carrying pollen, much like the branched hairs on the legs and mouthparts of modern bees. Dr. Labandeira and colleagues also discovered a group of scorpion flies which had mouthparts that included long proboscises in Myanmar amber. These insects had a specialized pump system to extract nectar-rich pollination drops from the reproductive organs of cone-bearing plants. Finally, alongside colleagues from Russia and Czech Republic, Dr. Labandeira discovered a fly from the early Cretaceous period, which exhibited the sponging mouthparts found in today's houseflies. The specimen they examined had pollen stuck to its face in a pattern often seen in some modern pollinating flies. The evidence points to insect pollination evolving during the Permian period between 300 million and 250 million years ago, over 140 million years before flowers appeared. During the Cretaceous Terrestrial Revolution, four major evolutionary patterns occurred in pollinating insects. Some insects, including false blister beetles, transitioned from cone-bearing hosts to flowering plants. Others, failing to adapt, simply went extinct. Some, such as thrips, persisted on cone-bearing hosts but were greatly reduced in diversity. Finally, new species originated with flower associations, including bees. In a recent study, Dr. Labandeira and colleagues demonstrated that diversity within insect groups plummeted during the Cretaceous Terrestrial Revolution, and then rose again after a period of insect adaptation. Insect pollination then drove flowering plants to become incredibly diverse, evolving complex floral traits to attract specific pollinators. Understanding the history of insect diversity is particularly important today in the face of plummeting insect populations. This research could aid predictions for how global events, such as climate change and habitat loss, might impact different insect groups based on their evolutionary history.